Thank you. Thank you. The other races were so consumed with grief and rage at seeing their world being destroyed around them in such a pointless manner that they also started to revert to magic. They tapped into vast reserves of power, collected and stored across many centuries. Terrible forces were unleashed at the attackers, people no longer bound by any laws and filled with an all-consuming hatred. However, the land was being destroyed in the process. Seas boiled, mountains were crushed, and volcanoes erupted. Even the moon was shattered, and the planet became unstable. Yet no one seemed to care. All that mattered was the overwhelming power and being able to direct this destructive force at the heart of the enemy. Then, one day, everything stopped. No new enemies appeared. No new attack came. No one had any illusions that the enemy had been defeated. People looked around and only then realized what they had done to their world. The damage was terrible. Most cities lay in ruins. Volcanoes erupted, blanketing the earth with ash. Storm clouds rolled day and night. Far above the ground, a black portal appeared. A window to Argante world. A sign that enough energy had been transformed and a bridge was possible. Most just surrendered or despaired, waiting for the inevitable. Only Proteus and his faithful Magi refused to give up. Proteus knew that it would take some time for the portal to be fully opened. When he visited the universe of the Argante, he learned about the differences in the law of physics. This bridge could not be destroyed, but it could be contained, and the entrance point blocked. He also knew that they had about 5 years before the connection became fully formed. 5 years to devise a plan to save the world, or 5 years before everything and everyone was consumed.